Guys, welcome to JAcademy, and this is the continuation of the Apriori algorithm. In the previous lesson, we have seen that how we can use to find the frequent item set in the Apriori algorithm. So after we have found the frequent item set, the second step for association rule mining will be to generate the rules, okay, or strong rules, okay. So first of all, I would like to tell you about the recap that what we have done in the previous video. So we had a transaction data which has 5 transactions, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and each transaction has certain items. Okay, from there, using the Apriori algorithm, we found the candidate 1 item set. So here the items are 1, so bread, milk, diapers, honey, egg and cola. And we calculated the support count. For example, bread is 4, we counted how many transactions has bread. Okay, similarly all the items are filled up. Okay, so the minimum support that we have taken was 3. So any item with less than 3 has to be removed. So here we have eggs, that is support count is 1, and cola has a support count of 2. So these 2 items were removed and were not considered to when we are forming the candidate with 2 item set. So how we have found the candidate with 2 item set? By doing the combination of each item with all the other items. Okay, and there is no duplicate items. So bread with diaper, bread with milk, and all the different type of combinations are done. Okay, and then we calculate the support count again scanning the transaction database. Okay, so here we got the support count for bread, diaper as 4, 3, 4, 2, 3, 2. So wherever it is minimum support is less than, 3, those item set were removed. So we saw that honey and milk has item set of 2, which is less than 3, and honey and bread are removed. Okay, then we found the candidate 3 item set. Okay, so we are left with bread, milk and diapers, and since honey, because Apriori algorithm states that if an item set is infrequent, then all the superset will also be infrequent. So there, since honey is infrequent, we cannot have honey here. Okay, so now, so we, after the step 3, we found the frequent item set. So my frequent item set is bread, milk and diapers. Here we are going to use the concept of confidence. Okay, like in the previous step 1, we have used support. Here there is a concept of confidence. So the formula of confidence, I want to give a recap. Confidence, suppose there is a relation x assumes y, then the confidence is equal to the support of x union y divided by the support of x. Okay, so this is the formula to calculate the confidence. Now in this example, we'll assume that the minimum confidence threshold is 80%. That means we will take all the rules which is greater than or equal to 80% confidence. Any rule where the confidence is less than 80% will not be considered. Okay, so now since we got the frequent item set as bread, milk and diapers from here, so how many rules can you form? The formula for this is 2 to the power of k minus 2. Okay, so that means 2 to the power of k is number of item 1, 2, 3. That is 2 to the power of 3 minus 2, that is 8 minus 2, that is equal to 6. So total 6 rules. So how can you find the rules? You can take a combination of 2 at a time or 1 at a time and form the rules. Since we have 3 item set, we can say that bread and milk, okay, in some of the book you can have it as comma here, bread comma milk, or they will give a operator like this. And so bread and milk implies diaper, bread and diaper give milk, milk and diaper give bread. Now that these are the 3 rules, and next 3 rules you can form by inversing this. Okay, so here you had bread, make the bread here, the other 2 components will come after the implication symbols, right? So like that you will get milk here and bread and diaper here, right? Then diaper, bread and milk. Now for each of the rules, we are going to calculate the confidence. Okay, how to find the confidence? For example, the first one, the confidence will be, you have to calculate the support of, because this is what is the formula x union y. So taking this x and this is y, so you have to take a union of them, so all of them. So it will be bread, milk and diaper divided by the support of x. So this is x, so that is bread and milk. So already from the previous step, or by the one time scanning, we can get the entire value of support. So bread, milk and diaper, we know what is the support count is 3. And what is bread, milk? So bread, milk is 3. So 3 by 3 is 1. So that is 100%. Similarly, what is the confidence of the second rule? Bread, diaper gives milk. So what I suggest is that if you have understood the concept till here, you pause the video and try to find the value of the confidence yourself. Okay? Otherwise, you can follow me. Okay. So what is the confidence here? I'm not going to write the formula. So for you to be very much, expert in this, you should keep on writing the formula in the first two problems or few problems, and then you can do it directly. So, can you tell me what is the formula? Yes. It is the support of all these three divided by the support of bread and diaper. So, what is the support of bread, milk and diaper? Bread, milk, diaper, the support is 3 divided by support of bread and diaper. I can get it from here. Bread and diaper is 4. So, 3 by 4 is how much? That will be around 75%. Okay. Next, you have milk and diaper. So, what is the confidence? Again, you take it together, you will get 3 by, what is the support of milk and diaper? Where is milk and diaper? Milk and diaper is 4. So, that is coming to 3 by 4 is 75% again. What is the confidence for this one? The bread implies milk and diaper. So, that is equal to your support of bread, milk and diaper divided by support of bread. Support of bread. I'll use B for bread. Okay. So support of this is 3. What is support of bread? Support of bread is 4. So this is going to give you 75%. I hope you have understood. Yes. Go for the next one. Number 5. What is the confidence in this case? So confidence will be the support of milk, bread and diaper, that is 3. What is the support of milk? Support of milk is here 4. So this is again 3 by 4 is 75%. Similarly, last one, you need to find the support of all the 3, that is 3. And the support of diaper, that is 5. So 3 by 5, okay, is equal to how much? So 3 by 5 into 100, 60%. Okay, so the minimum confidence was how much given in the problem is 80%. Okay, so now we have to check out which rules we need to check out, we need to consider, or which rules are strong rules and which rules we have to avoid. So we'll see the value of confidence. What is the value of the confidence of the first rule? It is 100%. So it is more than 80%. We can take this. Okay. What about the second rule having the confidence 75%, which is less than 80%? We cannot take it. Again, this is 75. We cannot take it. 75. No. 75. No. 60%. Again, we cannot take. So the rules that we will take is bread and milk. Gives or implies diapers. So this is the association rule that you got after using the Apriori algorithm. I hope you have understood, guys. Okay. In the next video, I'm going to tell you about the algorithm, step-by-step algorithms, as well as the limitation of Apriori algorithm, and then we'll go to FP growth. Bye-bye.